I've been pretty excited about this particular video for quite a while, not because it's like a product and I'm gonna endorse the product, but because this pedal right here has been such an intricate and integral part of my development as a drummer and of my career. So I was trying to add up how many hours I actually had on this. What I'm gonna be doing in this video is telling you about my experience with the Iron Cobra over 20 plus years, and then giving you the differences between the second and what I believe is the third generation that was released not too long ago. So you can kind of have a little education with that, what the big changes are. But this is the second edition of the Iron Cobra, and that's when it got kind of the classic Iron Cobra look. Before that, it was silver and real blocky. That was the 1993 version, and then 1998 they released this version, and that would have been right around the time that I got this pedal. So we're talking, I would have been 18 probably, and I would have gotten it for my birthday or for Christmas, one of the two, because we didn't do big purchases outside of that. It would have been a gift. And so this has been my main pedal since age 18. So we're looking at 20 years that it has been with me through everything. There was a brief period a couple years back where I wanted a new pedal and I got a Pearl Eliminator, and after a couple months quickly sold it and came back to this guy. So I bought the double pedal back in the day because I was convinced that one day I was gonna learn double pedal, and I'm still convinced that maybe one day I will, but probably not today. I just started gigging at such an early age that it just wasn't applicable for the things I was doing. Doesn't mean it's not applicable for you. It was for me. I was trying to add up how much time I've put in on this pedal, and you know, over 20 years, even if we're looking at just 10 hours a week, that's like 10,000 hours. But see, I played much more than that. I mean, starting at age 14, I was playing, you know, until age 19. So I was playing three times a week at my church, plus rehearsals for every time I played there. Plus I was practicing 1 to 2 hours a day, plus the bands I was in. At 16, I started gigging, doing stage shows, all those things. I was teaching lessons by 18. And then college, it was not unusual for me to pull 5 to 8 hour practice days, then all the ensembles, the big bands, ensembles at nights. I was gigging all the weekend. Then at 19, I got a house drumming gig on Bourbon Street. So that was a guaranteed 5 hours a day, 5 to 6 days a week. And then I boosted up to 10 hours a day of actual just stage time because I was pulling doubles for 5 or 6 month period, and then also practicing an hour or two a day. So when you're a working drummer, there's a lot of time that gets spent on your gear. This was a guy that was with me when I went on the road with my band, when I went on the road with artists. This was the one that went with me. So, I mean, we're talking tens of thousands of hours. I don't want to lie, but I mean, it's up there with, I would venture to say closer to 20,000 hours worth of playing, gig, rehearsal, sound check, all of that stuff. Never giving me a problem beyond a couple of minor issues. Always been, never broken. I had one piece that wore out. It may have been the cam, or it may have been one of these posts. I forget. And then the beaters have worn out in the past. I don't love the beaters that come with the Iron Cobra, so I buy aftermarket beaters. I like these. I prefer the round ones for me in my particular situation. The original one that came with this was a flat, more of a flat type of a deal. I snapped one of those. And the reason, this is a double pedal, even though I never used it, I always kept this second one on there because if I ever snapped one at a gig, I learned early on, I would always have a replacement right here. And sometimes I wouldn't be carrying the right bag and have another beater. So I always kept a second one right here. This one I was looking at, I thought about changing it out, but I thought it was a great story. So my beater broke, or this part, which is not a TAMA product, broke on a gig right before I stopped using this one and switched to this one. And the only thing I had was gaff tape. And so so I fixed it with gaff tape by just putting half a thing of gaff tape on this, and it's actually held really, really well. So there you go. If you have a pedal that breaks, when you're on the gig, you gotta fix it. So I'm very much a practitioner. I'm not like, you know, a technical guy. I if it works, I use it. So with this one, it's always been durable. It has never broken down on me to where I could not use it. I remember twice having to go in here and use the tools that came with it to actually adjust and tighten things up. Other than that, I literally took it out of the box and the factory settings were what I went with for all those years. A workhorse on the road, off the road. This thing has been thrown in and out of clubs. I'm probably gonna have to get shots after handling it because it's been on so many club floors, Bourbon Street, you know, Nashville, Broadway, all over the world. And it's always worked. So whenever I got invited to the TAMA event that I did where I met TAMA and was able to see them, the thing that stuck out to me was I immediately, like they're showcasing all these drums, I immediately went to the bass drum pedals because they were releasing a new version of the Iron Cobra. I was like, I gotta see what's going on. So this is the old 20 year version. This would be the second edition. This is the newer version, and if you get this straight from them, it's going to come with a black beater with it's about that big at the tip, very pointed. It is the only thing that I don't love about this, but the great thing is you can go on Amazon and get beaters if you want to. So, but a lot of people love them. I didn't like it. They say it has more attack and clarity and fullness body of sound. For me, I didn't love the way it treated my drum head, and as well, I just like these beaters. I've always liked the rounded beaters. So what's the differences between these two? One of the big differences is the pedal board is a little bit wider, and so it's a little bit of a firmer footing, footprint on the pedal itself. Another thing that I love that I always hated about this pedal was, and hate, it just aggravated me. All my bass drum hoops got scarred because this was metal. This was padded, but this was metal. By the way, this thing, the way it adjusts, allows you to fit just about, I've never met a bass drum hoop it wouldn't fit. So any situation, whether it be a little 16-inch cocktail type of a bass drum kit, anything, it's always fit there. And it's quiet. That's another thing about this, is a lot of pedals you have to worry with all the external noise they make, and in the studio, that's a big deal. This pedal has always just been really silent. Towards the last year I was using it, it started getting just a little bit of a rattle, but I mean, 20 years, what can you expect? So the way they fixed that was they actually put padding on this one. That's awesome, I love it, because it doesn't scar up my kit here. I love that. Another thing that they did is this guy right here moves now. So this piece, it'll actually pivot in its socket, and that means that whenever you're hitting, your spring stays straighter, longer, and less friction with the pedal. Anyway, it allows for it to be more stable and also more consistent in the feel. This one you can see doesn't move. It was just mounted right there. The other difference, I'm trying to remember all the differences that I saw. And this is, by the way, this is the reason I signed with the TAMA company, because of my experience with this pedal and with a hi-hat stand I had of theirs. I was like, if they make stuff that good, it's a done deal. So a lot of people think, oh, it's because they're going to give you. That's not how I do partnerships with people. I look at the product first, and I see, and it needs to be something I've had experience with. So there's a lot of great adjustments about this that make it wonderful. You can, all these small adjustments that make it just a great pedal. Another thing that they did was they took this piece and made it into two pieces. And so supposed to be a little bit more, a little bit better when it comes to reliability of the stroke, feeling good underneath your pedal. Another thing that they did that was the first thing I noticed, because I've been looking at this pedal for 20 years, and I'll try to kind of hold them up for you. I swear this thing is, I should have cleaned it before. So look at the bottom of the foot pedal there, and you'll see that they're different. So this is the older one, second generation, and right here you'll see the footboard comes here, and this piece comes in the middle. What they did was they were able to keep the same length of the pedal, but they were able to slightly move this back a little bit. And instead of this piece being the middle piece and this coming at the edge, this has the middle piece. Now, it doesn't seem like a big difference, but what that does is it extends the pedal a couple of inches. That's huge if you use heel toe. If you're going back, now if you're using slide, obviously it's not going to be as big of a deal. But whenever you're using heel toe, immediately the first thing when I put my foot on it, I was like, wow, my heel is not resting here. It's resting on the pedal. That was a big thing. Like right then I was like, I'm sold on that. That's a fantastic addition to the pedal. And then we have this spring down here. They've also added that to the newer version. I think that's about it. They hollowed out this, the Power Glide right here. They hollowed this out, whereas this was more solid in this one. If you can see that, I know this is a double pedal. They hollowed this out, and they say it's supposed to be 40% lighter. So that's a feature that, I think it's the Speed Cobra, that's a feature that they have there. So whenever they ask me, you know, well, what pedal are you going with? You know, Speed Cobra, a lot of people get it, and I could not get away from the Iron Cobra, because 20 years, tens of thousands of hours of playing time, dropped in and out of clubs, in and out of vans, buses, venues, you know, dingy clubs. I mean, and the thing has never broken down. It's just always been spot on, beyond a normal wear and tear. Tighten a couple things, and we're talking like 10 years into this thing. Tighten a few things, replacing beaters because those wear out. But it's just been a really reliable pedal. So I wanted to give you an honest look at the second and third generation here of the Iron Cobra and why, I mean, you're looking at the reason why I love the TAMA company is because it's the reliability of the equipment, the care that they put into the manufacturing and how the thing actually works. It's just above and beyond. And this is a great example that you have a piece of equipment that's been used that much on a professional level, which just means it's used all the time. Like, we use it in it. I mean, you know, you're not going to go into a drum store and find a beater that's taped like that. You'll find this on professional stuff sometimes because they were on a gig and something happened. This isn't even a TAMA piece. I guarantee if it had been a TAMA beater, it wouldn't happen. But I love this pedal because of the reliability of it. I can just take it out and it works. It comes in a hard case as well, so it makes throwing it in and out and loading and everything great. So it, just the fact that it's never broken on me on a gig is huge. I don't know how, because even if you play house kits, you bring your pedal, your snare, your cymbals. So this thing was being loaded in and out multiple times a day, and it's just never let me down. So if you're looking for a great kick drum pedal that's going to last you, the Iron Cobra's where it's at, you know. I mean, it was the most expensive that I was looking at the time, and I couldn't be happier that I went ahead and got it because it's been an amazing addition to, you know, my playing, my career, and my development as a player. Literally, this pedal has seen me develop as a player, which is an amazing thing. So if you're looking for a great pedal, the Iron Cobra is where it's at, in my opinion. If this has helped you a little bit, I know this has not been the most technical review. If you want technical stuff, there's lots of stuff on the internet that'll give you that stuff. I'm not a technical type guy when it comes to this stuff. I'm a practitioner. If it works, it works. That's what I want to do. I want to take it out every time and have it work. And this has just been, it's been amazing how consistently it's worked, how quietly it's worked, and how low maintenance I've had to do on it. I almost feel bad the lack of maintenance it's had for me over the years. So if this has helped you out, hit that thumbs up button, share it with somebody that you think it may help as well. Hit that subscribe button below this video. That way you'll be getting all the updates and all the new videos and contents that are coming out. Gear review, lessons, all kinds of stuff. I put out so much content, and you're missing it if you're not subscribed to the channel. If you ever need drum lessons, hop over to stevensdrumshed.com and check out a Drum Better daily membership. Leave me a comment. Let me know you stopped by. Whatever you do, I'll see you here in the next video.